Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see how to use Let's Encrypt SSL certificate on Tomcat. Let's Encrypt is a free, automated and open certificate authority. This will provide the option to generate a free certificate and that can be used for live purpose. To enable HTTPS on your site, you need to get a certificate from a certificate authority. Let's Encrypt is a CA. In order to get a certificate for your website's domain from Let's Encrypt, you have to demonstrate control over the domain, means the domain should be verified. There are multiple ways to generate the certificate. I will go with the zerossl.com. This provides very simple online tool to generate the certificate. So let me show you. Yeah, here you can go into the zerossl.com. This have some it's having some online tool. So even you can have the offline tool, but we can go with online tool. So I am already having a domain, test.albinsblog.com, pointing to the Tomcat server. So let me show you. Yeah, so I'm just accessing the Tomcat sample website through this test.albinsblog.com. You can. My domain is enabled through this Cloudflare. So yeah, test is pointing to my server. Okay, let's now see the steps to enable SSL with a Let's Encrypt certificate. Yeah, so let's first generate the certificate. So here go into this online tool, click on start. You need to enter, yeah, change the language. So then enter this, enter your email ID. Okay, now here you can see the private key and CSR. So this private key and CSR can be generated externally and pasted here, or you can leave it blank so that zerossl will generate for you. So this domains, if you have external CSR, so you can leave this blank domains list, or like you need to enter that. So I'm going to enter my domain name test.blog.com. So here, like, you can add a comma separated values of multiple domains. So yeah, now you need to accept the terms and conditions. Now the verification, there is two type of verification. One is HTTP verification and another one is DNS verification. HTTP verification means you need to keep some file in the server. You need to keep it in a particular location path. DNS verification means you need to enable some TXT record in the domain controller. So I am going with the DNS verification because I can easily do that through my Cloudflare control. Okay, now click on next. Yeah, it's asking you whether we want to include dubdub, but maybe live scenario we need the dubdub, but for me I am only going with one domain, so I am saying no. Yeah, the certificate is CSR is generated now. Okay, you can download this and keep it with you. So for the next time, for any certificate renewal or modification, you can use the same CSR. Yeah, now click on next. This will generate the private key. The default, the key size used to generate the key is 4096 bytes. So click on next. It will generate the key. The key is generated. Download this and keep it safely. So the next time you can use this key for any certificate renewal or modification. So this will help you to identify the existing domains and reuse the domain verification. So you are going to do a domain verification after this. If you reuse this private key, so it will be considered as an existing domain, and you can reuse that verification. So mainly you can use that for modification or renewal. Okay, now click on next. I missed to download it. You need to do that. Okay, click on next. Yeah, the key is now registered. You can see the message here. Now you need to, this is the verification step. So because I selected the domain verification, I'm getting a TXT record detail. Go into your domain control. Just select the type as TXT. Then keep your domain name. You don't want to keep the full domain, maybe albinsblog.com is not required anyway, it will be considered. Now copy that value. Okay, save that. This may take some time because it's a new one, so it will reflect immediately. So what you can do is you can use this website dnschecker.com to verify so whether it is added or not. Yeah, copy this and go to the DNS checker. Yeah, select the txt. Yeah, it's reflected already the same value. So once its changes are there, you can click on next here. Okay, the certificate is now ready. So you can see here the private key is generated and also the certificate. The private key is this private key is different from the account private key. So account private key is mainly to identify the account for the next time when you modify or renew the certificate. This domain key is for the certificate. This would be installed into Tomcat. Also certificate, you can see two section of certificate. One is two certificate will be there. One is the actual certificate. Another one is the certificate chain. Okay, let's download this now. Yeah, now the certificate is ready. So as a next step, we need to install the certificate on Tomcat server. So certificate can be installed into multiple levels, CDN, ELB, origin server. So we are going to install it Tomcat. So that means it is a origin server. Okay, now copy these two files into your Apache server config folder. So I will copy here. Now you need to rename this file certificate file extension to CRT, then this one to PEM, the key file to PEM. Okay, now we need to enable the secure connector in Tomcat. So I am using Tomcat 9.0 version for this configuration. So let me go into that. Open the server.xml. There is already some commented connectors, but I have used my own configuration because I want to use little different from whatever is there default. Yeah, so I'm using two type of connectors are there that is commented out. One is this one, another one is this one. So both are using different approach, but I am taking this configuration from this connector and I want to use the individual certificate because there is multiple option to use the certificate, include the certificate into Tomcat. One is PKCS 12, another one is you can convert that into JKS, then otherwise we can use the direct certificate. So I am going with this one. So if you see the configuration here, I enable the port 443, then yes, this one, then max reads SSL enable true, then host config, then certificate, the key file. That is domain key.pem, then a certificate file is this one. I am not going to enable the chain certificate for now. Let's see if it is working. A chain certificate is not mandatory, so if it is requesting for that, we can do that. Then you then type equal to RSA. So now this is looking fine. Okay, now let's go and restart the server. Go into bin. Okay, startup. Okay, looks to be the server is started as suspected. Now the 443 port is available, so you can go and access the same URL with the HTTPS. Yep, it's accessible and the certificate lock is shown. So if you see the certificate is valid, connection is secure. You can see the certificate is issued to test.albinsblog.com. Let's encrypt authority X3. So it's valid for 2024. It's around 3 months it's valid. Okay, now if you access the local host, that also will be can be accessed via HTTPS. Yeah, but only thing is it will show a certificate error because certificate is issued for test.albinsblog.com, but we are accessing the localhost, but you will be able to access through HTTPS. Yep. Okay. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.